ولكن تحديت الظروف وخضتها وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى محنتها، وكم كرهت مصابها.
Now to end off, right, to show you how your rulers are holy, the Muqaddis to you, and you'll do anything to back, you'll do anything to back, you'll defend your leaders to death. I'll give you an account, right, to show you how this Salafis, you know, obedience to rulers has gone so far. The neo-Salafis, should I say, pseudo-Salafis, Madakhila and whatnot. In Iraq, when the Americans invaded, there was a Salafi scholar, right, Yahya al-Kubaisi, who's a political analyst, journalist, he goes into it. And this Salafi scholar gave permissibility and wrote a book. Same thing with Rabi' al-Madkhali, we'll go into his book as well. He wrote a book deeming it permissible to aid the Americans, the invaders, and wrote a book, as you can see on screen, and he wrote a book basically allowing Muslims to aid the Mutaghallib, the Kafir Mutaghallib, not the Imam Mutaghallib, the Kafir Mutaghallib. Okay? This is how far this bootlicking methodology goes, this Salafist methodology, this neo-Salafist methodology. Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab was alive today, honestly. I fear for their fate. So let's listen to Yahya al-Kubaisi.
بعد دخول الأمريكان زين لديهم رجل سلفي داخل مدينة العلم اسمه أبو منار العلمي. هذا اخترع لهم فتوى مع دخول الأمريكان زين بجواز التعامل مع المتغلب، وأصدر كتاب بهذا الشأن. فكل بيت الجبارة مع أهل العلم صاروا ويا الأمريكان بشكل صريح، ثم أصبحوا صحوات، ثم أصبحوا حلفاء للمالكي، والآن هم حلفاء للحشد الشعبي. لا يمثل هؤلاء السنة.
See how far the Salafis obedience ruler goes. They some Iraqi tribes called Alam and Jubair or Jubar or whatever they're called. They basically aided the Americans. Then they become the Sahwa. Then they became the Hulafa al-Maliki, Nur al-Maliki, become their aiders. And then they became members of Hajj al-Sha'bi, who were notorious in slaughtering Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Human Rights Amnesty International Role reports on this. And here's the individual, as you can see on screen. This is Abu Munar al-Alami, okay? Abu Munar al-Alami, Salafi, obviously. As you saw in this video, we presented context. We have shown you how Faris Hamadi was deceptive and lied, okay? And he's shameless. When you follow this bootlicking methodology, you become a shameless weasel. Like Ibn Abdul Hadi, the book I presented, when he was speaking about the scholars of his time who were, you know, legitimizing tyrannical rulers, what did he call them? Khalbun Najis. They're filthy dogs. And that's why you are, Faris. You are a filthy dog. I'm just implementing what Ibn Abdul Hadi al-Dimishqi al-Hanbali said. You will be exposed. This will be continuous. We won't stop. We're going to highlight your fraudulent methodology. Take care. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah, go.
ليس الغريب غريب الشام واليمن، إن الغريب غريب الأحد والكفن، إن الغريب له حق لغربته على المقيمين في الأوطان والسكن. سفر بعيد وزاد لي يبلغني، وقوتي ضعفت والموت يطلبني. ما أحلم الله عني حيث أمهلني، وقد تماديت في ذنبي ويسترني. تمر ساعة